Ladies and gentlemen, our next speaker, as we celebrate Otumfuo in the Africa Premier Leadership Awards, is Senator Myron Jackson. Senator Myron Jackson is a senator in the Virgin U.S. Islands. He's actually serving his fourth term in elected office, Vice President of the 33rd Legislature of the Virgin Islands, chairs several committees, including Culture, Historic Preservation and Aging. He's also served over the past 30 years and researched, published widely in the area of cultural heritage, preservation, amongst others, receiving several awards. Please welcome Senator Myron D. Jackson as your ambassador tonight. All of our distinguished guests on this ceremony.
Your Majesty, the King for Osei, Tutu II, Your Excellency, the former President of the Republic of Ghana, the former Ministers of State, the countrymen and women of the Republic of Ghana, fellow brothers and sisters of the African diaspora. In 1982, I made my first journey in one of discovery of seeking our understanding of who we are as a people. I come from three tiny islands in the Caribbean known as the United States Virgin Islands. They were purchased from the Danish colonial government and the Kingdom of Denmark for $25 million in gold in 1917 for their proximity to the Panama Canal and the gateways to the Americas. For over 250 years, these islands were governed by Denmark. In 1733, the Aguamus of Ghana swung in this transatlantic slave trade, launched their first successful slave insurrection in the Western Hemisphere, and took the island of St. John for 6 months. It is the first documented and recorded act of self-determination by Africans in the so-called New World. Not too far from here, I had the opportunity to visit the Center for the honor of W.E.B. Du Bois. And on the wall, there is a portrait of the father of the Pan-African movement, Edward Wilmot Blyden, who was born at the island of St. Thomas in 1832, and subsequently traveled to the United States to enter into Rutgers University and was denied entry because of the color of his skin, and thus migrated to Liberia and settled in Sierra Leone. I bring you greetings from the people of the United States Virgin Islands. We are longing to make our reconnection to our ancestral home. In 1990, we had the opportunity to have reformed the nation from our government by the invitation there of the Minister of Tourism, the late Lanty, at that time. President Obama was seated. We made a commitment that we would do our very best to continue these relationships. And today, 2019 and the eve of 2020, I have returned to represent those Aquamoos who fought and struggled for self-determination and freedom and human rights. Much like that from the beginning, today, for it is formed. I would like to thank the Ghana Advocacy Group for the invitation and recognition of including me in this very auspicious occasion. I would like to also especially thank my very good friends who are here with me this evening. And they made this possible for my presence and likewise to represent countless others whose voices can be heard this evening. I want to give them thanks and also to wish you now as we forge forward with the return of the African diaspora as we build the legacy of this great continent of civilizations that we created. I wish you God's blessings and Sankofa. If you came, we would not see you. If you came, we would not see you. Rain won't fall, sun won't shine. If you came, we would not see you. God bless you.